The Indian River Lagoon is the most beautiful 156 miles of coastline on the east central coast of Florida. It is considered to be the most biologically diverse estuary in the mainland United States, so it is an area we need to preserve and protect.
We are testing oysters because some previous research that was in Mosquito Lagoon, which is the northernmost section, actually found some record concentrations of microplastics in oysters that originated from there. Oysters are filter feeders, which means that they filter some organic nutrients out of the water. One single adult oyster can filter up to 50 gallons of water in a day. So if we're finding these incredibly high concentrations of microplastics in these oysters and in the water, then there's a potential that we might have a serious issue here.
So the oysters can be taking in microplastics. Something like a juvenile fish is going to come along and eat the oyster. At some point, you know, one of the beautiful osprey that we have is going to come along and nab that fish. So if there is microplastics anywhere in that fish, they will be consumed by the osprey.
Audubon is a raptor rehab center, so we treat injured birds that come into us, so hawks, eagles, and owls. We do help a lot of different students with research projects, and Julia asked us to do one that was really unique for something that we've done here before.
So injured birds come into Audubon Center for Birds of Prey, and basically they will save birds for me that had either died naturally in the wild or within 24 hours of Audubon's care. I'm finding so much plastic. I'm finding an average of 30 microplastic fibers per bird.
I think the thing that surprised us with Julia's research is how many birds have microplastics in them. A lot of the things that we see in our raptors can actually affect humans, so they can be kind of an indicator species. If it's being seen in greater quantities, then you're going to start seeing people affected down the line.
We have a lot to do. I don't think we understand this particular problem enough yet to say that we've conquered it or even know how to conquer it. We can't come up with policy, we can't make regulations until we know what the problem is.
People just don't know what's going on. They don't know about microplastics in the environment. So by spreading and sharing your knowledge, you can create other passionate people that will then make a difference and create actual real change.